Okay, the trophy is set to go here. The race about 10 minutes away. The Arlington Million, 33rd Arlington Million, right here at Arlington Park. And you mentioned the Pizza Man, the Illinois bred horse, has a chance to make history here. The first Illinois bred to win this race in 33 years. Howard had a chance to profile the Pizza Man.
Over the last 2 years, the Illinois star, the Pizza Man, has gotten better and better. His jockey, one of Arlington's best, Florent Giroux, is excited to try to win the biggest race at the track that is his home base.
It's our race, you know, that's a signature race. You know, it's been there, you know, since the last 25 years, and it's a very, very good race.
How confident are you in him?
No, I'm very confident because you need to be confident before each race, and we have a horse who's running two times this year, won two times.
The Pizza Man is locally owned by Midwest Thoroughbreds Richard and Karen Papise. So in a nod to their hometown and our love of pizza, it was natural to name him the Pizza Man. But there's another reason.
If you take a look at him on his forehead, he has the markings of a slice of pizza. They called from the farm when he was little, and they said, "Hey, this horse has a marking that looks like a slice of pizza. Chicago pizza." And I talked to the farm, and I said, "Well, you know, what do you think?" And they said, "Well, we just told you what we thought." And I said, "Well, I'm good with it."
So now this unique horse with the memorable name is poised to take his run at the very best in the world. The owners considered running him in today's American St. Ledger, which he won last year, but the Papises feel he belongs in the Million.
The Pizza Man has dug his heels in. Dandino Walhart, it's the Pizza Man. The Pizza Man with his biggest delivery yet.
We owe it to the horse. We owe it to the trainer. We owe it to ourselves. We owe it to the fans. We owe it to Arlington Racetrack. And above all, we owe it to Illinois Racing to run in that race. I feel really good. I feel as good. I told my wife on the way here, I feel as good about this race as going into Breeders' Cup. And again, not to be cocky or anything, I wouldn't discount us here. I wouldn't trade places. As great as all these other situations are, all these other horses, all these other trainers, riders, I wouldn't trade positions with anyone right now.
Wow, what a story that is. And Howard, the odds are getting better, right?
Well, they are. Up to 9-2 now on the Pizza Man. And I give the Papises, Karen and Richard Papise from the south side of Chicago, Midwest Thoroughbreds, all the credit in the world for taking a shot at the Arlington Million. The horse deserves it.
Okay, the race right around the corner, so stay with us. And welcome back with a race now just a couple of minutes away here, the 33rd annual Arlington Million. And let's go to Howard and Eddie for their picks. I got still got time to bet this guy, so hurry up.
You do. Here's what I'm thinking. And if we win, we will contribute to the money, the Permanently Disabled Jockey Fund, PDJF. My picks, $100 bet, $10 exacta box, 4, 10, 11, and a $10 exacta, the 11 over the 2, 4, 7, 10, the 11 being Maverick Wave. Alyssa is betting a $15 exacta box, 4, 7, 11, and $10 to win on the 10 triple threat. Eddie?
Well, I'm going to box up four horses. I'm going to use the, for a dollar box, 2, 4, 7, 8, meaning that any combination of those horses finishing 1, 2, 3, you get the trifecta. I'm going to bet $40 to win in our favorite Big Blue Kitten, 3-1. Well, actually, now second choice in behind the two-horse Slumber. And I'm also going to play an exacta, meaning that the four has to win. So I'm going to play a $10 exacta key. Four has to win the race, and either the 2, the 7, or the 8. To me, the 8 horse, to me, is Quiet Force is the key, because I think that horse can be sitting second in behind Shining Copper. Big price at almost 24-1.
Okay, let's get a final pre-race word from Alyssa. Alyssa.
I am here at the starting gate before the Arlington Million. We talked about the Pizza Man. The Pizza Man definitely is acting like a pro out here. He's warming up with the pony. He is very calm, cool, and collected. That's great to see. The number 3 Book Runner was without a pony, as often Europeans do, but he was a little bit excited and kind of pulling his head up with the jockey, but I think he's calmed down quite a bit. And I do want to take a look here at the gate at the number 1 hole. We talked about Up With The Birds and Drayden Van Dyke breaking from that one hole. Take a look how close it is because of this 13 13-horse field. He breaks really close to that rail, so he's going to need to make sure he breaks very sharp. A huge field here for the Arlington Million, and it's going to be off in just a couple of minutes, and we're really excited to see it. Back to you guys.
All right, Alyssa, thank you very much. The horses nearing the starting gate. We're proud to announce our corporate partner this year. Also, it's the International Festival of Racing, featuring the Arlington Million, presented by Liftmaster. And we're about a minute away from post right now, and the money is coming in right now on the two, Slumber Ed, who has kind of taken turns beating or running against and beating Big Blue Kitten. They've kind of gone back and forth with each other.
Yeah, the last couple of races, they flip-flop order. Slumber finished second in the United Nation in behind Big Blue Kitten, and then the race prior to that on Belmont Day, on American Pharoah Day, winning that Triple Crown in New York on June the 6th. Slumber turned the tables on Big Blue Kitten. So again, I mean, the key to this race is going to be the 9-horse. Shining Copper going to go to the lead. And again, I keep going back to the 8-horse, Quiet Force. I think this horse has tactical speed to be sitting. I'd like to see this horse being sitting second or third. And we've heard a lot about the Pizza Man. I think the Pizza Man does his best running. It's going to be a fast pace. He's probably going to be 8, 9, 10 lengths out of it, try to make that one run. So the speed of the 9 is really the key to this race, to see how it all unfolds the last eighth of a mile.
There's no question about that. And the horse is going into the gate now for the Arlington Million. So to recap once again, Eddie, my pick on top is Maverick Wave, the 11, trained by John Gosden, in from Great Britain. And you are all over Big Blue Kitten.
I'm going to take a shot with the 4-horse, see if Chad Brown can win this, win the last two races, winning the Beverly D and now winning the Arlington Million.
And there is the rabbit for Big Blue Kitten, the 9, Shining Copper, going into the gate, ready to go, and will go to the front in this race. No question about that, I don't think, Eddie, as long as he breaks like he usually does.
Yeah, well, not getting in there too quickly, I'll tell you that right now.
No, but he'll come out quickly, won't he, Ed?
Yeah, yeah, that's his style. And now the starting crew. Now we have a jockey off on the
book
the
runner
three
on
horse.
The 3.
And that was the horse that Alyssa had made mention a little bit earlier. Was giving the jock a little bit of an issue.
Looks like they're working on the bridle. A little bit of a equipment change there, or not change, but we have an equipment malfunction, Ed.
Yeah, wardrobe
malfunction.
Exactly.
There you go.
Exactly. Trying to make a little bit of an adjustment.
A little rain delay, a little equipment malfunction.
The horse looks a little bit washed out, too, but it is 90 degrees. We're washed out, too.
We almost were washed out earlier with that heavy rain about an hour ago.
Not just from rain, from the sweat. It's pretty humid now.
It is. A very hot day, 90 degrees, of course, so when the day began here, but rain cooled off just a little bit. And back to Alyssa.
Hi. We're looking here at the number 3 book runner, as I was talking about. He was kind of fighting the jockey, warming up. He's pretty washed out here, but everyone checked him out. Jockey is back up aboard. He looks okay. They were checking out his bit and bridle, but all looks good. They're going to continue to check it out, but he is back on, the jockey is, so that's always a good sign. We'll see if he goes into the gate a little bit smoother than he has been right now, waiting to get in.
And the jockey of the 3, book runner, Gerald Mossy, and they are starting to load once again for the Arlington Million. And the odds right now, we're holding steady with Slumber at 3-1 and Big Blue Kitten also at 3-1. And my horse on the outside, really surprised to see Maverick Wave at 7-1.
It's
from
a great
the barn.
Wagering board.
I think it is. Yeah. If you hit it, you're going to get paid.
Some big bucks. We're still entering the gate here. Again, a little bit delayed because of the rain. And Grace coming right on the corner. A couple of minutes away, I would think, less than that, as he gets to the gate, depending on when they can get in. One horse delaying it, and we're up coming in, and they're going in slowly but surely.
And the Pizza Man is at 5-1. So, like I said, the 2 and the 4 are the co-favorites right now at 3-1. And we're going to send it up to track announcer John G. Dooley for the call of the 33rd Arlington Million.
Wake Forest, purple white hoops to post 5. Legendary. Laurent Giroux with the Pizza Man facing up to the gate. As a cheer goes up here from the stands for the Pizza Man. Five to one to win the million, the Pizza Man. We're several minutes past due from million post time. Maverick Wave, Elval, ready now for the Pizza Man. A moment away from the start. Last load, Jamie Spencer with Belgian Bill to make up the 13. At a mile and a quarter, they are in the gate. They're off in the Arlington Million. Shannon Copper being sent. Shannon Copper, the Arlington Handicap winner, Quiet Force, Legendary, and Bookrunner in the front ranks, along with Maverick Wave and the Godolphin Blue. It's Shannon Copper. Shannon Copper has come away in front. Bookrunner taking a hold up to settle. And on the outside is Maverick Wave as they come past the stands. And it's Shannon Copper who leads the way from Maverick Wave and Bookrunner in third. Legendary is fourth and settled as they make their way toward the first turn. Shannon Copper out to lead the way from Maverick Wave and Bookrunner. Maverick in fourth. Up with the birds, stays rooted to the rail. Next as they round the first turn, outside up with the birds is Legendary in fifth. Wake Forest in sixth between horses, Purple White Hoops. Then on the outside, Quiet Force, Slumber right there from the rail. As they go to the back of the course, the Pizza Man is mid-pack. And then comes the 13-time winner, Big Blue Kitten, together with Triple Threat. It's a break of two more then to Belgian Bill and Elval is last of 13 going up the back of the course. The quarter, the fastest ever in the million, 21 3/5 seconds, half mile in 46 3/5. They head to the half mile pole in the 33rd Arlington Million, and Shining Copper continues to set the tone, and it's a robust pace. Shining Copper by two, Bookrunner is second, Maverick Wave third. As they enter the turn, Legendary starts to quicken now. Maverick Wave is dropped back, up with the birds at ground saving fourth. Quiet Force now into fifth, Maverick Wave sixth, then dropping back to three furlongs out. The Pizza Man clear of horses and gaining seven from the front. And then on the outside is Big Blue Kitten, who's gaining with Triple Threat. At the inside, Elval, Belgian Bill, Slumber, Maverick Wave plummeted back to 13th. In the meantime, it's Shining Copper. They turn for home. Shining Copper with 3/16 to go. Shining Copper leads by a length. Shining Copper here's up with the birds coming up the fence. The Pizza Man finishing now. Big Blue Kitten charging on the outside. The Pizza Man has taken the lead. The Pizza Man on the outside. Big Blue Kitten. Chicago's about to erupt. The Illinois bread. The Pizza Man just won the Arlington Million under Florent Giroux. Big Blue Kitten was second, and Shining Copper finished third.
Wow, what a story. The Pizza Man, Howard.
Oh, my gosh, Fish.
First history's made. First time.
That's one of the most exciting horse races I've ever seen because of the story and the circumstances of it. The Pizza Man gets it done. Eddie, they didn't know if he was good enough. They thought he deserved the chance to try. And listen to the crowd going wild out here as the Pizza Man wins the Arlington Million for the Pepisas.
Had the perfect trip. Great ride by Florent Giroux to be able to sit, wait. The speed was there. I mean, the nine horse hung around.
Wow. Sure did. Yeah. Very game. Had unbelievable fractions in there. And Big Blue Kitten ran his race. He is always right there. Eddie hits the board frequently. He's run 27 times. He's hit the board 24 of them, 25 of them now out of 28.
But you see the four horse Big Blue Kitten in the yellow saddle cloth on the outside there. The Pizza Man saves ground, is able to weave himself out. You see Florent Giroux going left-handed, gauging the speed of Shining Copper, the nine horse, and is able to fend off Big Blue Kitten, who had some issues coming around the far turn. Had to check just so slightly.
He did, a little bit wide.
Yeah,
also.
And then he had to re-rally and stick handle his way through the traffic. But the Pizza Man delivers.
Wow.
As Jean G. Dooley has said many a times, the 10th career win for the Pizza Man. And congratulations to Midwest Thoroughbreds, Roger Brueggemann, the trainer, Rich and Karen Papise, and Illinois Bred winning the biggest race in our state, the Arlington Million.
That is unbelievable. I talked to Rich and Karen all week long. Rich was quietly confident and very hopeful, and he said if he wins, the party's going all night long.
Wow. Must have been his choice of wardrobe when you were interviewing him.
Yes,
with that Stanley Cup champion Blackhawk jersey.
That's right. The Blackhawk jersey on. Look at the aerial shot there of the crowd back out in the sunshine right now, and they couldn't be any more thrilled as the local star gets it done.
Okay, let's go back to Melissa with more on the post-race coverage. Melissa.
Owner Richard Papise. Richard, what does it mean to you?
What does it mean to me with the way things are in Chicago and Illinois right now? This belongs to Illinois, not to me, not to my wife or me or our family. This is for Illinois. Karen and I sat down We've been talking about it every night. This is for Illinois. Illinois Racing, all the fans.
This is for Illinois. We do. Congratulations. The connections of the Pizza Man. What an amazing story, guys.
It is. Incredible story. The first Illinois bred to win this race. And what a great race it was. Even had a lot of steam down the stretch.
And how about congratulations to Alyssa Ali for her bet. She had a $15 exacta box, 4-7-11, and it came 7-4. That's going to pay big to go to the PDGF, the Permanently Disabled Jockeys Fund. I hope she had it, too.
Okay, back with more. Recap here after a break on WGN.
The Arlington Million has been brought to you by Chevy. Bet on a sure thing at your Chicagoland and Northwest Indiana Chevy dealer. Their summer sell down is going on now. Go to ChevyDriveChicago.com for details and bring it home. And by Miller Lite, the original light pilsner. Cheers, it's Miller time.
Roger Brueggemann. Roger, you're a man of very few words. Do you have any right now?
Really, really happy. That's not all I can say.
All right, your horse is coming in. The Pizza Man. Congratulations to Roger Brueggemann. The crowd is going wild for this Illinois bred, guys. Just take a look. I mean, this means so much to Illinois racing. A huge congratulations to the Pizza Man and Connections.
Alyssa did quite a job there to get an interview with Roger Brueggemann, because he doesn't do interviews. But I guess when you win the Arlington Million, you've got to speak up. And, Eddie, we've got the prices. The Pizza Man in the winner's circle now, to the cheers of the crowd, pays $13.60, $6.60, and $4.60. And the runner-up, Big Blue Kitten, at $4 and $3.20. And Shining Copper ran a big race and hung in there the entire way. Red Hot Fractions paid $11.40 to show.
And you think about the difference, that there was some talk that the Pizza Man was cross-enter, meaning it was thinking about running in the seventh race, American St. Ledger. That purse was $350,000. The Arlington Million, obviously, $1 million. Quick calculation, that was probably a $400,000 difference in decision by Midwest Thoroughbreds. And again, I can't emphasize enough the ride by Florent Giroux to put the Pizza Man in an absolutely perfect spot. And again, home cooking, home course, makes his 10th career. I don't know if he likes pizza. Probably, you know what, there'd be a lot of people here buying him pizza.
And a great name, yeah.
Yeah, absolutely. But just congratulations. And I loved how Rich Papisse talked about this being for the people of Illinois, the state of racing here. And it is just great to see an Illinois bred to be able to win such a huge worldwide race, not only in the state, the Arlington Million, but, I mean, this race is known worldwide.
Well, it does so much for breeding in the state. Yeah. So happy for the Papises. So happy for this crowd out here. Everybody that bet on the Pizza Man, and a lot of people did, as he pays $13.60. And Illinois bred wins the Arlington Million.
Great story. We lost some weight up here again.
You know what? You know how you put that back on? Let's go have some pizza. Rich.
That's right. It's the Pizza Man. Okay. Thanks for being with us. And see you a bit later on. Take care.